'cause you're amazing, just the way you are. And when you smile, the whole world stops and stares for a while. 'Cause girl, you're amazing, just the way you are. Yeah. It's a beautiful night, we're looking for something dumb to do. Hey baby, I think I wanna marry you. Is it the look in your eyes?
The children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children laugh. Remind us how we used to.
found anyone who fulfilled my needs. A lonely place to be, so I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I'll live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the bravest love of all was happening to me. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I'll live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all was happening to me.
Take you away from me. Would you please remain standing for grace, please? Thank you. For the food and wine we're about to receive in the company of the family and friends of Joanne and Russell, we give thanks. And may the happiness of this day remain with you both for the rest of your lives. Amen. Amen. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. Thank you.
I'm especially pleased to welcome my brother from the Northeast and his family. In addition to Russell's parents, also Uncle David and Auntie Pamela have come from Mönchengladbach in Germany. When seeking advice on what I should say, I spoke to Michael, and he said I had to say lovely things about John. Well, that's not so easy in a small speech as this. Joanne is a very caring, friendly person who values personal relationships. The proof of that is in the relatives and friends who are here today. Friends from the early days at Blackfield and Harvey School, Oxford Brookes University, from my travel, and from Thomas Cook, all of which still stays in contact with, and others who are not here today. Of course, that loveliness is coupled with a determination, which I've no doubt Russell has already experienced. An example of this, and it's no secret, that at the age of 12 years old, on a flight to USA, she told us she wanted to be an air hostess. Her determination saw her through going to university and gaining a degree, but carried on with her main ambition to be an air hostess, a job she continues to do today after 11 years. Needless to say, Angie and I are both immensely proud of everything she's done. Of course, no Father of the Bride speech could be complete without some comments about the group. Russell had been to our house a few times, and we started to recognise a man with good family values and similar qualities you can see in John. This was shown perfectly well last Christmas Eve when Russell asked Angie and I's permission to propose to John. A point we much appreciated. He duly did so on Christmas Day, and here we all are today. We are very pleased to welcome Russell into our small music-loving family and trust him that his music education has improved no end. And then trust him seriously with our most treasured possession, Joanne. So, in conclusion, it's my pleasure to propose a toast to the happy couple. So please be upstanding and raise your glasses to toast the bride and groom, Joanne and Russell.
Family and friends, pray silence for the bridegroom, Mr. Russell Campbell.
Cheers, guys, thanks. Seats ready, I've had loads of food, so I should be fine. Basically, guys, you're going to be unsurprised to hear that I left this speech to the last minute. It's not that I'm lazy, although some of you may say otherwise. I'm just too laid back for my own good. So I irritated a few people at work and I read a book or two. And to tell you the truth, I did consider copying Mum, thanks for the English GCSE. But then I remembered, sorry, I was reminded that I was supposed to write the speech. So here goes. I'd like to start my speech by welcoming all of you, all the guests. We're surrounded by most of our friends and family. You've all been important to all of us throughout most of our lives. And some of you have travelled far and wide, so thank you. I know it's going to sound like a bit of a cliche, but I truly am the happiest man, even though I did flake out twice. That wasn't in the speech, I just thought. I'd just like to say on behalf of my wife and I. I'll be asking you to raise your glasses a few times during my speech, so don't drink it all in one go, Smithy. This is part of the speech where I'm meant to tell you how I met my wife. It's a bit long-winded, as some of you may know, so I'm going to keep it short and sweet. Essentially, I first met Joanne on the 5th of November 2005. Keeps it easy for me, doesn't it? Gunpowder Treason plot, bonfire night, Linfield, Sussex. I had my bum in the air and my face in the dirt. And as most of the boys know, rules is rules. So with Dutch courage, I promptly asked her for a kiss, and unsurprisingly, she said no. Cut a long story short, I moved to the California in the US of A, wasn't related. And Joanne became a pen friend. We talked regularly by email and Facebook. And in June 2007, I took a 24-hour train ride from San Francisco to Vancouver to see her as she flew in with work. And I'll admit it, I fell in love. In December 2007, I returned from the US of A, and being the stubborn fool that I am, I wouldn't take no for an answer. And as I say, the rest is history. Steady on. So I wasn't going to blub, I flaked, I'm not blubbing. Michael and Angela, I'd like to take this opportunity to truly thank you for all your love and support. You've made me feel like part of the family. Sorry, but I'm not happy. I'm happy. One day I might be able to do the cop master. I've never really said the words, so I'd also like to thank you for raising such a beautiful, gorgeous, stunning, intelligent, caring, compassionate. Is she blushing yet? spaciously aware and DIY efficient. Honest, you see all the spirit levels, drills, and screw drives since we have. They're all in pink. She's great for putting up a cupboard or two. I'd also like to take this opportunity to thank my mum and dad for their love and support over the years and for welcoming Joanne into the Campbell family. I know it's hard to believe, but I haven't always been perfect. My mum and dad helped me over the years and they've seen me through thick and thin, mainly thick if I'm being honest. They've always stood by me, literally speaking, and I hope that I've done them proud. Mum, Dad, I really couldn't have done it without you. Thank you both for everything. Thank you. First, we'd like to present our mums with a small token of our appreciation. Oh, yes, thank you. I'm sure you've seen the trio of smart-looking gentlemen who have clearly been supporting me. More than I thought to be honest about. So I'd like to thank the groomsmen, Stephen, Paul, known as Wingman, and Sam. Unfortunately, I have one missing groomsman. Our good friend Toby and his wife Susie were unable to attend due to the impending arrival with baby Gerald. We've got a note here that says, add baby info if known. Nobody knows. Hope it's all going okay. Thanks again, gents. We've got a little something for you three and the other guys, and Downton bits and pieces. Yeah, come on guys, if you want to crack on up and around the map. We'd also like to thank our fantastic quartet of bridesmaids, Fiona, Jenny, over there somewhere. Beth being a bridesmaid. Thank you for all being there to support Jo Ann on this special day. I know it means a lot to her. Ladies, you look amazing. Taylor, looking dapper, sir. We thank you again. Ladies, if you haven't already located your presents, they're under your chairs. Enjoy the warmth. And Taylor, we have something a little more manly for you. Just like to come on up. Gentlemen, can you please be upstanding again and raise your glasses? I'd like to propose a toast to the bride's people.
To the bride's people.
Enjoy saying that, for agreeing to marry me and making me the happiest man in the world. I think you all agree that she looks absolutely amazing. And I'd like to say I saw you walk up the aisle, but I waited until you got next to me. And not only did you take my breath away, you took all my blood sugars. Don't marry someone that you can live with. You marry someone that you can't live without. And I think that sums us up perfectly. You truly are my rock, and you make me happier than I ever dreamed I could be. And I intend to spend the rest of my life making sure the reverse is also true. I never normally have a problem finding the right words to express my love for Joanne. But if I start now, I probably won't stop, and I might even cry. I love you so much, and I look forward to growing up. So this is honestly the last toast. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding and raise your glasses. I'd like to propose a toast to Joe.
To Joe.
Best friend. We've had some amazing experiences together, too numerous to recount here. Although if anyone's interested, most of them are loaded up on Facebook. They're not pretty. I'm sorry. And I'd just like to say, from me and most of the lads here, the Stag Do was an absolutely amazing weekend. And I think you all thoroughly enjoyed it. Please be nice and try to remember your next sunshine.
Father and mother of the bridegroom, family and friends, pray silence for the best man, Mr. Ian McCampbell.
I'm a teacher and it feels unnatural not to be stood in front of a class of children, so if I treat you like children, I'm really, really sorry. But there are some sheets of paper and a pen on your table. We're going to play a game of, it's basically speech bingo. So I'm going to come up with loads of words throughout my speech. You've got to write them down, so you've got to get three in a row. If your table shouts out bingo, you win a lovely prize. You're not allowed to use nouns or pronouns. So it's things like unconscious, falling over, fainting, being sick, eating chocolate might come up in this speech. So feel free, I'll give you a minute to write down as many as you possibly can in the boxes on your table. Go. But anyway, if you come in, so, the only thing is, just going to say, Toby said that he's sorry that he can't be here today. Unfortunately, wait for some news, so hopefully we'll find out soon. So, as you might have guessed, from the same hairstyle, physical stature, height, and many other characteristics, Russell and I are actually brothers. You know, it's not that dissimilar. So it's great pride that I stand in front of you as his best man, something I've waited to confirm for 29 years, 8 months, 6 days, 2 hours, and 32 minutes. Good. So, when I started to write this speech, I realised what a really, really hard task this was going to be. How can I put into 30 minutes the impact that my brother has had on me and many of you gathered in this room? So get comfy, have a drink in your hand, and we'll get cracking. So I thought hard, sought help, spoke with many people, spoke to a self-professed wise man. Cheers, Dad. And arrived at some key points. He's a generous individual. On several occasions, he'll dip into his pocket to buy drinks, gifts, and lend people money. The best example of this was shown when I was just 16 years of age. It was the night before a really, really important GCSE exam. I don't find sort of maths really, really easy, so you know I've been training hard. Mum and Dad got me a maths tutor. Done my prep, been ready for ages. I was about to get a good night's sleep, but that was broken by Russell. He decided that he'd forgotten his keys, went out with Paul, cheers mate, thanks for that, and Steve and a few other people, came back and decided at 3 o'clock in the morning to start lobbing pound coins at my window, to which I promptly woke up, got down, and I got to share his generous and loving company at 3 o'clock in the morning. What was even better about his generosity was that Jenny, our little sister, found £7.34 dotted around the dotted around the garden, which she then promptly spent. Another key attribute that he has, he's caring. Many times he's looked after me and his friends. When Jenny was a little bit younger, he would look after her as well. When I was younger, me and him used to be well into our army, into our action things, running around using little plastic men, grenade. And he launched this acorn grenade, and it landed in my eye. It was a really lucky shot, but it ended up really hurting. And one year, Jenny was also really unwell, and Russell spent the time and he built her a little snowman outside the back window so that she can enjoy the snow, enjoy that Christmas as well. He's a narrator. He likes a lovely story about planes, absolutely anything, really boring. He's a comedian, an enthusiast of history, a learner. He's come leaps and bounds, you know, and talking about doing degrees and stuff like that, which is absolutely fantastic. He's protective, even if unintentional. So Russell and I were in the TA together, so he decided that I didn't want to do an 8-mile speed walk in the middle of December. I didn't want to do it. So he decided without talking to me, that in front of 30 recruits, loads of NCOs, that he would knock himself out, knock himself out on his rifle. So we're doing this little manoeuvre, he's running along, and then he jumps on the floor, headbutts the rifle, out cold. So I get summoned by an NCO, and this resulted in us being carted off to A&E, and I got some really nice attention, got some bacon sandwiches, the nurses were lovely, lots of cups of tea, and then we finally sorted out Russell and got rid of him. Cheers, bro. But he's got plenty more attributes. His strength is love, friendship, and many others. The love he has for Joe has been clear to see from the moment that they met. So I've got a little bit of advice for you, Joe. If ever there is something you want doing or preventing him from doing, droning on or moaning about something, remember these few words. I think I heard a World War II plane wherever. So Russell's passion for planes should mean washing up could get done. I heard an engine. Look out the kitchen. While you're there, why don't you do this? Apart from that, I know that Joe and Russ will have a wonderful life together. It is a great honour to welcome Joe to our family. You have made him truly happy. Your kindness, friendship and love will stand with you in wonderful shape for a happy marriage. So, that's it. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding. Charge your glasses. I give you Russell Joe, Mr. and Mrs. Campbell.
Mr. and Mrs. Campbell.
Propose a toast to absent family and friends. So would you please stand? And the toast is to absent family and friends.
Absent family and friends.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. Before we conclude, and please remain at the table as they know, we're going to have some lovely coffees and teas after. But it would be remiss of me not to thank a few people once again. Firstly, of course, it's Katie, Tim, and all the wonderful boys and girls at Ryan's House who did a wonderful job at your drinks reception here at the wedding breakfast. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, your appreciation for the Ryan's House. We had some wonderful music once again played by the wonderful Emma, the harpist, of course, during your drinks reception. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, appreciation for coming. And I've worked with many professional photographers in my time, and I can assure you, ladies and gentlemen, this gentleman's up with the very, very best of them. Your appreciation for Neville from Lightree. Neville. And of course, yourselves for bringing a present here today. Give yourselves a big round of applause. We had an interview with Joanne and Russell. It was mainly Joanne, I must admit. But during the interview, four things really came to the forefront they wanted. The first they wanted was good weather, and we managed that. The second they wanted, of course, was good food, and coming to Ryanfield was never going to be a problem. The food's been fantastic. The third they wanted was good fun, and for myself going around all the tables, I know everybody's thoroughly enjoying themselves, and I know this evening will be no different. But the fourth most important thing I know they wanted was good friends. And I know from the bottom of the heart they thank you being here for this special day. Now, my name is Michael Judd. I am a professional toastmaster. And as you know, I am a traditionalist. And I do have the first champagne cork that was popped today. Please keep it in your bottom drawer. You'll always have money in the house. May I wish you both every success, health, and happiness in the future. And I've been very proud to appreciate your very special. Concludes the breakfast. Would you please stand as prime bridegroom remains seated?
Funny how it seems, always in time, but never in line for dreams. Head over heels, went toe to toe. This is the sound of my soul. This is the sound.
Thank you. through now to midnight. Don't forget, put your song request into me. Want to play what you want to hear tonight? Let's go.
Of my